What's up, YouTube? It's me, Joe Schmo, and before we're hopping right into it, I just want to say, I never preference this, but I went down to go see PD and Ace, PD's my editor, for those who don't know, and I was in South Carolina for the whole trip. So, for those who don't know, real quick, South Carolina is becoming a real hotbed for video games due to the fact that SEGE, which is the largest video game convention on the East Coast, is like there. So, I ended up going, and we went around, and I did a bunch of cool things. So, let's hop right into it.
Good morning, hello, good evening, whenever you're seeing this. We're doing something a little different today. We're down at the Game Garage here in South Carolina.
What, Spartanburg?
Spartanburg.
Yeah, in Spartanburg. Yeah. I got PD with me, by the way.
Hi.
Yeah, we're gonna go in. I already talked to the store owner, because I ask before I do all this stuff. But yeah, we're gonna go talk to Presley, I believe is his name. I'm bad with names. But we're going to go in there, and before we get in there, I already traded in stuff. Cars are very loud outside, but I got about 85 in store credit, and we're going to cash that in and get some stuff that I want, but we'll go in. That, can I get Age of Calamity, Hades? I know for a fact, because I've been looking for Age of Calamity for a while. It's beautiful.
What is beautiful. Age of Calamity?
Age of Calamity. Remember I was playing the Hyrule Warriors?
Oh.
Yeah, okay. So this is essentially what carries over into Breath of the Wild.
Okay.
So, since I already played the first Hyrule Warriors, you can play the second one on stream.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I know that for a fact. Okay, I'll just get Collection of Mana, and now I'll take out the rest of that. Mm-hmm. Alright, bam, there goes
all the store credit taken care of.
Problem is, like, I got so many consoles, I don't know what they get. That's the problem.
How many consoles are you up to?
I think I got 13, 14. And I mean, when I did the reselling stuff, just to try it out, I mean, I should have kept some of the consoles because I went through Atari, Segas, all that stuff, but...
Just flipped it.
Yeah, just flipped it because I was trying it out to see if I can do it, but then, you know, some personal stuff happened, so I had to stop. Probably the craziest thing that I have is I had this just literally hanging out in I call it my storage room. And when we were getting all of our stuff together, my buddy Griffin was like, man, what is that? He's like, I mean, look at that. Is it so Christmas sealed? Why is this thing not protected or anything like that? And we kind of don't want to do graded stuff. So he's like, man, let's put a good price on it. You send that thing to get it graded, it's going to get a high grade. You're going to double, triple your money. Well, that's amazing. You should probably also introduce yourself. I mean, just start it going. But introduce yourself. Talk about, you know, how you got here and whatever you want to tell the public.
Chewing this up.
Yeah, go for it.
Yeah, you're good.
Sorry.
No, you're good.
My name's Presley Bright. That's my business partner, Griffin, over there. We were literally just, you know, buying collections from each other, trying to fill in our own gaps, and we decided one day, hey, let's get together and do this thing for real. We put our collections together, and here we are.
Yeah, no, you got a really cool store. Like I was telling you, compared to what I'm used to back at home, this is like, it's nice, neat. You got a huge variety of stuff. And then, even as there was traded in stuff, which you can see right there, I mean, I got a very good price on everything that was just extra lying around that I didn't need. So, I do appreciate that, because honesty is very rare nowadays, but
we try to go the extra distance. You know, we've been on the other side of the counter a long time, so we kind of know how most people tend to do.
Yeah.
You know, people trading collections and stuff. It's want to have a place you can walk into. My hands place is nice. You can chill, relax, get a coffee, look at a bunch of cool games, and hang out, you know?
Yeah, so, all right, well, we're going to take a look around, and then we'll come back.
So me and PD and Ace, we ended up going to the Banger Flea Market, which is a Greer, South Carolina, or somewhere around there. But there was a lot of good things that came out of this. There was a lot of good shops. There were permanent game shops in here, which is the reason why we ended up actually going to this flea market instead of the one near Spartansburg or wherever you're going. But yeah, there was plenty to offer, so here you go. The next place we went to was Upstate Games in Greenville, South Carolina. Now, I saw this place multiple times on different YouTubers such as Retro Rick, Pixel Games God, Capture the Chase After the Right Price. This place was fantastic. They had a lot of good inventory, a lot of good things. They even have a side for just Pokemon. They have old arcade cabinets, display things. It was a dream come true to actually be able to step inside of this place. And, well, here you go. Here's some more footage of it. Another cool place we ended up going to, which was around the corner, was Toy Federation. And same channel as I listed before, there's a lot of cool things. They have MASH figures here that I really want, which I'll probably get next time. But they got a lot of cool collectibles, a lot of cool pop figures, or pop culture stuff. A lot of things that you guys might like. So here you go, have a look. Alright, so I just went into this thrift store. It's, what is it called? Carol's Hope. Ended up getting a Hannah Montana seal, which apparently is the best thing I've found all this trip, according to some people that I know. Hannah Montana! Yeah, see, look. So, and then I got Gran Turismo 4 and Ace Combat 5. And I'll show those later on once we get back to the house. But, yeah, let's keep on hunting. One of the cooler ones that we found near the end was the Video Game Cavern, which is in Greenville, South Carolina. It's been there for like 25 plus years, and they have a World of Nintendo cabinet, which I'm showing you right here. It's such a good find to finally see one of those in person. It's one of those things on my bucket list that I would like to own, but being able to see in a person, look through all these different types of banger of games, it was such a good, valuable experience to go in there and talk with the staff and be able to search around and look. And I even picked up a couple little bags there. So here, enjoy some more footage. One of our last stops was Mr. K's used books, CDs, like they had a whole bunch of different things. It was also in Greenville. That was a very good and resourceful place. I picked up a lot of stuff for BoxerChan. I picked up a little bit of stuff for me, which you'll see. But very good, cool place, good prices. Go check them out if you're in the Greenville area. But here's some, here's me looking around looking like an idiot.
All right, so instead of going home and doing it, I literally bought too much stuff that it would take me forever to do it by myself. So I got PD in the background. He's going to pass me some things.
Item.
This is my new microwave. This is my new cabinet. No, I'm at PD's place. They went with me with Ace, and we went shopping. And so we're going to go step by step and talk about some things I got. So, I ended up getting a Animal Crossing New Horizon lamp. It's brand new. Ended up getting that.
Only at Target.
Only at Target at Ollie's. Then I ended up buying something for, not for a gift for someone, which I won't even go over that. But then I found this fanfic called The Last Pokemon Master. Basically, what happens if Pokemon Go became real and destroyed the world? That's what that is. There you go, for those who are actually interested. Well, yeah, that's what Ollie's had for us.
I'll just start with Ollie back here. Go inside of the way.
Then we went to a couple different thrift stores that I honestly don't remember the name. And we went to a pawn shop. Ended up getting some Wii Wheels, which I didn't have any. So I ended up getting that for $7 for both. Ended up getting Vampyr for the Switch. I got Gran Turismo 4. Ace Combat 5. And then I got the pride and jewel of this whole hunt. Hannah Montana Sealed. Yeah, Hannah Montana Spotlight World Tour Sealed. Got those for 5 apiece. Everything's complete in the box. Decent games from the thrift stores and stuff. But as we continue, things start ramping up with what we bought. For me, as people know, I'm a World War II nut. And I got a VHS player recently. So I got a bunch of old commemorative like stuff talking about certain events, like Pearl Harbor. And why we fight World War II. So it shows a bunch of footage, a bunch of different things that you kind of can't forget. It's kind of important.
Stick that back there. Have that ugly mug looking at me the whole time.
Then we went to a Habitat Restore and we picked up a couple things. Most of the anime goods, and I'll point out what's for me, is going to Box of Chance. So if you want a chance at them, just go check out Box of Chance. Picked up My Hero Academia. What was it? Two Heroes? Yeah, picked that up for $1 sealed. I picked up Letterkenny for me, season 5 and 6. I picked up When Marnie Was There, I think that's what it is. It's a Ghibli film. Got that for $1. PD found Assassin's Creed Valhalla for the PS5. Got that for $1. And then I got the Fortnite The Last Laugh, which tempted a resale because it goes on Amazon for $60. So that's going. The two animes are going to Box of Chair there. Then, all this stuff, we went to, what is it called, Mr. K?
Yeah,
which Mr. you saw the footage. They had a bunch of stuff. If you're a music guy, person, gal, they have lots of records, lots of CDs, movies, DVDs, books. They had all types of media. And I was able to find One Piece Red for cheaper than Walmart. So, yeah, this is going to me. As a lot of you know, this is a movie that makes me cry over and over and over again. So that's staying with me. And same for Justice League versus the Teen Titans. Never seen it. Heard it's very good. It's going to me. But the rest is going to Box-A-Chan, which we got Akira for $5. We got this Pokemon Forever for $3. Destiny Deoxys for $5. Giratina movie for Pokemon for $5. And then I picked up Higurashi When They Cry for Oxygen. So that's all nice stuff. And I think I spent about $60 for the lot here. Which, I mean, is a good price for 3-ray manga that no one really gets to see anymore. Then we went to, this is the Game Garage, right? Yeah, the Game Garage. So, and you saw footage of me talking with one of the co-owners there. Very nice people. One of the best experiences I've had going to a game store for the like first time ever going in there. Very knowledgeable. Very cool guy. traded in stuff, and I got, like you saw, I got a lot of cool things. So I got Hades, Hyrule Calamity, Age of Calamity, which we will play on stream, link. Got the collection of mana, which is Final Fantasy Adventure, Secret of Mana, and Trials of Mana. I'll get to them eventually, because I've been wanting to play Secret of Mana for a while. Then I got the best game that ever came out, Duke Nukem Forever. It was a big letdown. Waited 20 years, and they let us down greatly. And then I got the dual pack that comes with the original Xbox, Tetris, Clone Wars. Very fun game, underrated. And then I got the tri-pack. So this has Super Mario, Duck Hunt, and World Class Track Meet. This is another variant of the starter ones that I got. So now I just need to get Duck Hunt, and then I'll have the original variants that came with the NESs. So that's a good starter kit for that. Next up, we went to Upstate Games. And if you're a game collector that watches like Retro Rick, people like Chase After the Right Price, Pixel Game Squad, Phoenix Resale, you saw that right after Siege, they went to this place. Staff was friendly, very knowledgeable, had a very good time looking around, ended up getting some small cheap stuff. Got Shaolin Showdown, sealed, with manual, not sealed, complete in box with manual. I got Word Jong, complete in box. Then I ended up getting Monster Trucks for the Game Boy Advance, with also Quad Desert Fury, complete in box, all the manuals, everything in there, inserts there, beautiful. Then I ended up getting 3D Pool, complete in the box, inserts, manuals, all that stuff. And then I picked up this, Smash Brothers for the Wii U and the 3DS. Very underrated, a lot of people hated it because of the Wii U thing. I really enjoyed it, I don't know why people hated it, but they did. So, yes, all this was added. Also, there'll be a final total count once I add everything in. Of the games at the end. Alright. Speaking of Upstate Games, there is a toy shop that was nearby called Toy Federation. Very cool place. They have something that I really want, and I might end up going back later on when I get the money. But lots of cool toys, if collectible, like old action figures, they got anime stuff in there. Not for me, for Boxer Chan, but giant All Might pop figure, $10, and it's like really good shape. There's like a little scuff, but I mean, it could be rubbed out. Like, very cool, folks. Nice. Good business. Then we went to, what was this one?
The Video Game Cavern?
The Video Game Cavern. Apparently it's been in the area of Greenville for 25 plus years. Saw a lot of things. That's where you saw the World of Nintendo cabinet. God, see one of those in person, like, it's a very nice treat. I ended up getting a couple little things. I got me a little Game Boy Color pouch. I got me a little Game Boy Advance little pouch here, which very nice, very, very clean. And then, hey, look. Yeah, the video game cabinet. Forgot to put the card on the inside there. There you go. All right. Now to the big thing you saw on the thumbnail. We're going to take this piece by piece. So me, PD, and Ace were walking around. Couldn't figure out anything to find. Everything was all right. I mean, there was, you know, it's a flea market. Ended up, first thing I found was this old Duel Master toy thing. So what happened, I think Burger King was the place. They give you Duel Pack, they'll give you Duel Master cards inside. I think it was three. And they come with this cool little tray. A little holographic, cool. Went to a comic store. They had these little things, the Pokeballs. Cool little things. And I believe the figures would go like right there. But I think this was, 2015. Something cool, something, you know, just a little, you know, little cool piece for the background. Which I could put Teddy Ursa that I got. Look at that little thing. A little 3D printed Teddy Ursa. Very nice. So, as we were walking out, we were about to leave, and we saw they had a little outside port. So I was like, all right, I guess we can go. Then Peter's like, no, let's go. PD found some stuff for a project they're working on, which they'll disclose at some point. Very cool, but not my room to talk about. Then we found this little Meryl. didn't know if it worked or not. They wanted $2. Okay, cool. PD had some watch batteries. And I think the tail is supposed to move at some point. But it works. It works, speaks. Has Japanese writing on the bottom. So, like, it's really thoroughly enjoyed. As we were leaving, I saw the corner of my eye. This car in the very far left. Saw what I thought were some video games. So we walked over. It was VHSs and some movies. And I saw some 64 games sitting on top. Well, Petey saw like a VHS recorder or something that was sitting there, a receiver. They went to go look at it, and the people thought we were looking at the 64 stuff. They're like, hey, I got this stuff. They pulled out a whole bin of like top tier classic games. Mario Party 1, 2, 3, Mario 64, Mario Kart, Mario Golf, Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask. They pulled out a bunch of these big hitter games. And in the corner of my eye, I see some boxes. I go to the guy, I was like, what's the story on this? Apparently he just went to an estate sale right before going to the flea market, got a bunch of it, bought the whole lot for $250. And I saw this in the corner of my eye. I was like, you got anything else? He's like, well, I got this one. I was like, how much do you want for him? He said $30 for both. So I paid the man $30 and shook hands, called it a day. The only problem is that, you know, there's a little, I can get that off. It's a little grime, get it off. But everything is in there minus the game. So for $30, I saved $200 because the manuals were $16 a piece. The boxes are $100 a piece. So now I just need to get the games and I'll be done. So yes, my trip to South Carolina, very good, very fruitful. So here's the full total score. There's the total amount of games we're up to. There was a haul. I don't know what I'm going to label this, but this is also a game hunting video for the archive. So let me know what you guys think down below. Tell PD and Ace you said hi, and I'll see you all later. Bye-bye. So just kidding, that's not the actual final total. I forgot that I bought stuff from PD and Ace. So, if I remember correctly, the Super Nintendo may or may not work, right?
That one, it powers on, but it does not seem to actually, like, display anything.
So, I bought this so I can start learning and teaching myself how to fix stuff. So, I bought that. Hi, Mr. Kitty. I don't remember what this is.
That's an NES that I was not able to test because I didn't have any cartridges.
This is a weird looking NES.
Yeah.
So we'll find out more about that. I got all the bits and bobs in the box. But I also got games. I ended up getting Super Mario World, Mortal Kombat, Super Star Wars, what is it? Wizardology 5?
Yeah.
And I got Star Fox. So, yeah, I got. I didn't even think about it. I bought an NES game.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we could test that.
Test it.
But, yeah, so I'll let you know down in the comments if it actually works. But, yeah, like I said, say hi to Ace and Petey. And now here's the real total with systems and peripherals added. And, yeah, I'll see you all later. Bye-bye.